Yo, what's up guys, welcome back to another video. In today's video, we're going to be going over how to make a cheat for games. Using C++, we're going to be writing process memory and getting addresses with cheat engine. So we're going to get just right into it. Alright, so the first thing we're going to do is open up cheat engine. And we're going to go ahead and attach it to our game. So to do that, we can just go to applications here and select the game. I'm going to be using a game called Idle Slayer. We just picked it off the Steam marketplace because obviously it's a kind of a small game, doesn't have an anti-cheat or anything, and it's data isn't stored in the database, it's stored locally in the memory, so it doesn't check with any external things. But if you do use cloud saves, then that could contradict with it. But if you change the values before you cloud save, then it'll just save your local values to the cloud, which is really what you want for like leaderboards and stuff. But anyways, we already touched it actually. So yeah, so we're gonna go ahead and take put this over here on my second monitor. You won't be able to see it. We won't use it right now. We're gonna open up an empty project, and I'm going to call it Idle Slayer. Okay, we're gonna do this by console, because we're not gonna worry about DirectX 9 rendering right now. So we're just gonna make our source file, and then we're gonna rename this to main.cpp, and we're gonna have our int main, of course. Okay. Oh shit. Okay. There's our int main. Gonna add return 0 here, break out of it. Okay, let's add our include. So we're gonna do include windows.h, and we're gonna also include IO stream. We're also gonna add using namespace std, because it gets kind of annoying, and this is also a small project. Let's get right into it. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to print something to the console that's kind of you know what, we'll just actually make the cheat first. So the first thing we need to do is see if the window's even open. So we first have to get the process the Windows ID. So we can do this by doing window, the handle, the window ID, and then we're gonna use find window A. Okay, and A holds two parameters, but we're only gonna need one, so we can use null, and then we'll just have our parameter, and our game is called Idle Slayer. So we're gonna type in Idle Slayer, make sure it's the same capitals and everything. And okay, so that's our find window function. We're gonna do if our handle window, then we're going to continue, and then we're gonna go below here and add else, and we're going to put std c out. Actually, we don't need that std because we have c out, and then we're gonna put process not found. Is it open? Okay, and then we're going to sleep for a second, and then we're going to just return 0 here. So that's just going to exit our program. So if we have if we find the window, then we can find the process ID, and the process ID changes every time you open and restart a program. That's what happens when you do it Windows. So to find it, we're going to use a D word. And then we're going to call, we're just going to make a new variable up here and call it, we're sticking with this. All right, and we're going to make it proc ID. And we're going to have this D word equal to, I think it's, I forgot what the fuck it is. Oh fuck. It's get thread. I gotta get the thread. So let's get thread from I think something like that. Hold up. Sorry. Yeah, get window thread process ID. And then we take a look at the parameters this includes. So this has our handle, which we already have, so we declare it right here. And obviously it has to be true because this statement is basically saying if this exists, we can run this, and then if it doesn't exist, you can do that. But and then we have our next parameter, we have our process ID, and obviously we don't have that. So what we're gonna do is add a reference to oh wait. Alright, we're just gonna get rid of that, and then we're gonna do that. And we don't really need to initialize it because we're just gonna reference it right here. Here we go, proc ID. So what that's gonna do is it's gonna return our process ID to our D word there. And we can add if proc ID, I keep forgetting this because I'm used to Lua. If proc ID, okay. So if our process practically exists, we're just gonna print process found. We're gonna add a not found case here. And then we're gonna add a else statement under here. And then we're gonna go to not found if it's not found. So if it's not found, it's just gonna go down here. And it's gonna do that. And yeah. So it looks a bit neater. Oh fuck. Fuck am I doing? Like I said, just so it looks a bit neater, we're just gonna put it in brackets because I like to be neat. But we're gonna say process found, and then what we're gonna do is we need to write our memory. So before we write our memory, we're gonna start with a for loop. So I'm just gonna do okay. There's our for loop, and then we're gonna do we're not going to use anything in the for loop. That's why we're putting two semicolons. And we're just going to print to the consoles. Actually, no, we'll do a key thing. So if get async key state. And the way you find the key you want is through the table. So I have a list of virtual key codes pulled up. I'll leave it in the description too. But these basically just tell you all the constant names. And constant names are only for like special keys, like clear, enter. But for actual keys, like letters, they are numbers. So we're going to do the C key, so which is 67. So we're just going to give ourselves coins. This is my doc, by the way. I would like you guys to invite you to join this. I made this specifically so I can help out people. Just contains a bunch of useful stuff, but... Anyways, if we get 67, so if we click C on our keyboard, we're gonna do this. So we're also gonna add a case up here, and we're gonna call it begin, and so we can go back to that. But what we're gonna do here is we're going to write our process memory, and we're gonna leave it right here. And we're going to make a header file. And we're gonna hit right here. We're gonna call it hold up, I gotta fucking offsets. And there we go. Okay, and here we can define our variable. So we're gonna have LP void, and then we're gonna convert our base address to an LP void here. And we're gonna call m underscore points equals, and then we're gonna have 0x0 right now. So, it has no storage type. Okay, this is because we need, should call it. Oh, I have the syntax wrong. I'm stupid, sorry, I'm tired right now. A good time, it's 12:51. Anyways, we need to declare it first, and then we have to convert the base address to, LP void. What the fuck? Let's clear it now. It's undefined. Okay, well, it won't be defined once we define it. But so, yeah, you see, because the base address needs an LP void. See, LP base address. So that's why we use it here. If you're wondering. We don't need to do it because we have pregnant once, so we can just include it here. There we go. So there we go. So now we have it included in our actual main function, and it's not undeclared, which is nice. So there we go. This actually has to be an actual value though, so let's go find it. So let's go into our actual game. And let's use cheat engine here. If you've never used cheat engine in your life, you better get to using it if you plan on making cheats, because that's how you're gonna find your addresses. Other way would be reverse engineering, which is substantially harder, but it's a lot more effective. It's kind of easy though once you get the hang of like assembly code and all that. You can use like IDE Pro and x64 DBG. But all right, so what we're gonna do here is let's see if we can try and see what happens here. If we can, okay. So I noticed that it's the sword adds 0.1, which must mean that it's a and it's coins, so it must be coins. Usually hold at least eight bytes. Not at least, but like they hold a lot of bytes because you obviously need your coins up, like, because you know you need to get into your billions, millions. So, I'm gonna assume this is a double. I don't really know, but we're just gonna go with double and hope it's right. Okay, so we're gonna scan for 12 on a double, and obviously we have 8,000 values, so we're gonna have to go ahead and increase the value. So we're just 14. Okay, so now we're gonna scan for 14. Okay, and we have a bunch of values stuck in here, so let's go ahead and keep that up to 15. We keep doing it, okay. And if we do it one more time and they don't go away, then we're just gonna figure out which values which. Okay, so none of them went away, so all of these addresses must be related to coins. So we're gonna take all of these and bring them down here. I did this by control clicking, or you can just control and drag, or just drag normally and then hit this red arrow. So these addresses are all very similar, these C21 addresses. So what we're going to do is we're going to change this value to 200. Okay, you see how, okay, so that didn't change at all. So that means it's definitely not that value. Okay, so now we can see that the coins are increasing in double value, so it's definitely one of these. Yeah, okay, it's not that. It is okay, so we found the correct address. So you notice how it's correct address, because when I changed the value it actually changed. So this must be the correct address. So all we have to do is copy this address, and let's go ahead and add it right here. Make sure you have 0x0, because that will happen, because it's not an actual base address. So now we can just get straight to it. So we're gonna go ahead and write our process memory. So take a look here. So we need our handle. We already have that. We have everything we need. So, oh, we don't have our handle actually. Wait, is it asking for, we're forgetting to open our process. That's, okay, so, under here we're gonna do handle handle open process, and then here we can have our semicolon. Okay, so we need our D-word desired access, so we can do if you want to get the desired access list, okay, actually get rid of that. So here are all the process rights. So we have right here all this, and we're gonna want all access when we open the process, so we can edit whatever the fuck we want. You can read that if you want. I'm not gonna explain it. Read it. Anyways, put that there. We need our we don't need to use that. Yeah, okay. So what this means is if you want to inherit a handle, and we're creating one, so we don't really need to do that. And then we need our, is that process ID? Yeah. Okay. So then we're going to put in our proc ID. Proc ID. All right, there's our handle. So now let's go ahead and write to the handle and our base address. We already have offices included, so if we do M underscore, coins comes right up. We need a reference to that, though. So we wanna, our buffer. So for the buffer, what we're gonna do is up here, we're gonna create a a double, because we can't create an int or whatever, because our value, our address we're trying to change is a double address. So we're going to do double coin value. And then we're just going to initialize this one. Hold up, I got to fucking get off insert. We're going to initialize that. There we go. And then we're going to put, we're going to get rid of this, and then we can put a reference here. Okay, and then we need our size, so we can just do size of, and then we need our numbers of bytes, so 0. Okay, and that should work. Let's see what happens. Okay, we actually don't even have a set value, so we're just gonna set this to 1000.0, see if it works. Okay, so it does work. So that means we wrote the process memory correctly. If you're following up to this point, congratulations, you wrote process memory. But what we're going to do now is we're going to make it so the user has an input on what they want. So we're going to do sin coin value. If sin fails, we're going to return, see out invalid value, then we're going to turn 0. We should exit our program. Let's go ahead and just, yeah, I'll sleep it a little bit. I'm gonna sleep. Okay. So now if we hit, okay, it's already getting our sin. So let's just see out. Enter your, I gotta new line this. I don't have a backslash on my keyboard. So I'm just gonna get one. Oh wait, actually there's one right here I can get. Well, I do have a backslash, but I'm using it for like screenshots and shit, so. Enter, oh shit. Enter your desired coin value. And then Now if we hit C, enter your desired coin value, put in like a bunch, and we'll do like 500. And it puts in 500. And we hit C again, does it again. We can just keep changing it. Okay, because it's just going back to the beginning. So let's make it clear the screen instead, so it's a little more better. So this is easy to do. So when we write the process memory, we're going to do go to. Begin. And then we're going to do. We're just going to. In the beginning, we're going to do system CLS. That will clear the screen. Okay. So, there's our thing. So now if we go in here, press sound, we hit C. Let's go ahead and make the hotkeys. So, we'll do process found. Instead of process found, we'll do C. We'll just do fucking key. I should do C. And then we'll do dash change coins. So there we go. Hit C. And we're gonna also clear. Oh, wrong place. We're clear screen here. Goes right back. Enter first coins, and of course it's changing, right? Okay, so we're just gonna make another value, just because, you know, two values. So I'm thinking we edit this coins per second thing. I'm gonna assume that it's also a double, because 0.1, and you know. So we're gonna do a scan. There's 31 million. So we're gonna increase it and put it on 0.2. And we're gonna put it to like 0.7. Yep, and that gives us 2. We'll do 1 if it doesn't show anything. Yep, okay, so these two values are either way. So let's just go with this value, put 50. Not that value. So it must be this value. I stand corrected. We're gonna copy that address. Hit the Visual Studio, and then we're gonna go to our offsets, and we're gonna do LP void M underscore CPS for coins per second, and we're gonna convert that to an LP void address right there. And then we're gonna go make a just a little note here, call it value holders. We're gonna call it double CPS value, initialize that, and we're just gonna use the B key. Oh no, we're gonna use the D key, 68. So let's go. I'll do if get async key state 68. We're going to just copy everything that's here. Changes to CPS value. change this to m_CPS. Change this to the CPSA. And we're gonna get the size of CPS value. Use that. Should work too. Let's just go ahead and count another thing for D. Change CPS. So now if we launch, hit D. Go like 100, or I put 1,000, but you know. But obviously, if you go too big, it's gonna just give you all the coins. So you gotta do like something like that. And if you look at cheat engine changes, yeah, that's how we do that. In the next video, I might show you how to make this same thing, but incorporated with IMGUI, because I feel like that could be really interesting. So I hope you guys did enjoy, and I'll see you guys in the next one.